Thank you. especially when my body's clearing 40 and my mind is nearing 10. I can hardly stay up, and I can't get to sleep, and I don't want to wait tomorrow morning at the bottom of some heap. But why take it so seriously? After all, there's nothing at stake here, only me. I want to be young, and I want to be old. I would like to be wise before my time, and yet be foolish and brash and bold. I would like the universe to get down on its knees and say, Guido, whatever you please, it's okay, even if it's impossible, we'll arrange it. That's all that I want. Taking it to excess, one limitation I dearly regret. There's only one of me I've ever met. I should like to have another me to travel along with myself. I should even like to be able to sing a duet with myself. I would like to be here, sing along with myself in a song, to be there, walking down a lane now, everywhere,
everywhere,
everywhere. That's a contradiction in terms. I want to be here with a melody, here in the counter, here, top of the morning to you, Guido,
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 me, me, me. I want to be Proust or the Maki de Sade.
I would like to be
Christ, Muhammad, Buddha, but not have to believe in God. And you know I mean it with all of my heart. It's the end if something important doesn't start. I want to be young, but I have to be old. What I want is a tale of sound and fury that some idiot went and told. I would like the universe to get down on its knees and say, Guido, whatever you please, it's okay, even if it's ridiculous, we'll arrange it.
Very, very, very ably assisted by my friend here, Rebecca Eng. And together we're going to take you on a little tour of musical theatre. I've spent certainly the better proportion of my life singing, acting, and messing up Broadway songs. So I feel quite able to take you on a little tour of some of my favourites, favourite composers, favourite songs. And as you'd expect, a good place to start would be at the start. Ooh, just quickly though, Guido's song. The last time I sung that song, the lyric was, my body's clearing 20 as my mind is nearing 10. So we're going to go back, not quite to the start, but very close to it, to the old-fashioned musicals. We're going to go back to George and Ira Gershwin. It was a beautiful one. It was one I did in the Lower East Side of Manhattan, just before I met my first wife. My only wife. Okay. She's in the audience. She's the one not laughing. And this is from a musical called Gay Divorce. And it's just a beautiful song, After You, Who? After you, who could replace my skies of blue? After you, who could I love? the Lower East Side. I'm going to demonstrate something for you. Oh, would you be so kind?
So, the music is, the musical is, sorry, no, it's okay. The musical is, I forgot what it was. I Lady Be Good. You know,
Oh, sweet and lovely Lady Be Good. Oh, Lady Be Good to me.
And I'm playing the role of Jeffrey White, who's like a jazz singer, guest turn sort of thing, which was very common in those star musicals. The non-story, it was slot in a jazz number. So, I was singing a song called Little Jazz Bird.
I'm a little jazz bird and I'm telling you to be one too. And a little jazz bird is only happy when you sing in blue.
Anyway, so,
I'm singing this and lovely room, kind of like this, I can see people's faces. And I see one of my friends in the audience and I'm just there, I'm a little jazz bird and I'm telling you to be one too. And I smiled and went, because a little jazz bird is only happy when he's singing blue. Same reaction. And it was then that I learned the important lesson, you cannot whistle and smile at the same time. Needless to say, my friend was in absolute hysterics, and I spent the rest of the song going, as best I could do at the time. Anyway, carrying on with Mr. Gershwin, though, his brother Ira. This is a little curve. This is one of my absolute favorites. This is Ira Gershwin and Kurt Weill. I don't know how many of you, we're really going back to the Kurt Weill, Beggar's Opera, Threepenny Opera, and things like that. I'd like to give you a song called A Rhyme for Angela.
It's always been my pleasure to dedicate a measure to the lady who intrigues me at the time. Diana and Roxanna and Lana and Susanna were names I sang in rhythm and in rhyme. Cordelia and Ophelia, Cecilia and Aurelia inspired lovely lyrics from my pen. But Angela is something else again. I could find a rhyme for Lucy. For instance, her lips are juicy. But I must confess, I'm lost more or less with Angela. Angela! I could find a rhyme for Chloe. For instance, her breast is snowy. But rhyming is when you've got a name like Angela. Angela, if only her name were Olivia, she might be a cute bit of trivia. If she were called Maria, or even Dorothea, she'd be my Solaria divine. I can find a rhyme for Irma. She's heaven on terra firma. And Angela's got no patter. And yet, what does it matter if Angela's heart rhymes with mine?
Don't clap, Rose is way behind. Way behind. I'm blaming you guys for turning it on to the light. Super duper. Next song. So this is partially an operetta. It was a British show by Vivian Ellis called Bless the Bride. This was a massive hit in its time. It was just post-war. And it became a big hit. I think because there was a really not very good song about war. Actually, no, it was quite nice in the show. So I'd like to give you a little song from my native England. They may notice the accent is slightly different. In September, when the grapes are purple, Margarita picks the grapes with me. There are silver bells upon her fingers. All the little birds come out to see. Rob and Margarita, so beautiful to see. Le Monde, ma petite, Margarita picks grapes with me. A ting-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a In October, when they feel the wine press, Margarita treads the grapes with me. Margarita has the feet of angels. All the little boys come out to see ya. Margarita, so beautiful to see. Le pied de ma petite. Margarita treads the grapes with me. A ting a ling a ling a ling a ling a ling a ling a ting a ling a ling a ling a ling a ling a ling a ting a ling a ling a ling a ling a ling a ling a ting a ling a ling a ling a ling a ling a ling a. Who has a glass of wine out there? Because we are at the verse which the French do best. In December, when the wind is blowing, when the snow is on the broad sea, sunshine still is in the golden glasses. Margarita drinks the sun with me. Oscar Hammerstein II, writing with Jerome Kern. This is a show called Showboat, a show I was in at the Royal Albert Hall in the West End. And it was dealt with racial inequality, sexual inequality, all of these things, which isn't bad considering it was 1927. Luckily, they solved it all very shortly afterwards and it was all fine. So that's good. Anyway. So it was either this, so I either had to sing a song that's unsingable, or sing a woman's song, or sing the breakout song from the show. And it's amazing and it stands up today just as well as anything.
Just keeps rolling.
is soon forgotten, but Old Man River, it just keeps rolling along. You and me, we sweat and strain, bodies all aching and racked with pain. Tilt that barge, tilt that bale, you get a little drunk, your land's in jail.
An American person playing a British person. That's not confusing, I don't know what is. But, from the musical My Fair Lady, The Street Where You Live. I have often walked down this street before, but the pavement always stayed beneath my feet. At once am I several stories high, knowing I'm on the street where you live. Are there lilac trees in the heart of town? Can you hear a lark in any other part of town? Does enchantment pour? Yeah. Assuming he probably had a, you know, one in five failure rate. God knows how many there are in his back library. Now, the marvellous thing about, even better than that, he could only play piano in one key. F sharp major. How many sharps are in F sharp major? Too many. Could only play in F sharp major. He had a piano specially built. It's worth a fortune now, and I don't know who has it, but it had all these pedals. And when he wanted to change key, when he wanted to modulate, press the pedal, and the whole keyboard would go. The whole piano would go. It was amazing. Anyhow, so that man, he wrote all of these up-tempo, over there, and grand old flag, you're a high-flying flag. But, in my opinion, his masterpiece was the musical Annie Get Your Gun. And there are so many hits in Annie Get Your Gun. So many that you'll know even if you don't know the show. There's no business like show, business like no business I know. Got no diamonds, got no pearls, still I think I'm a lucky girl. Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you. Yes, I can. Yes, I can. So many more, but I'm going to sing one of his ballads because, you know, his up-tempos were all sort of really famous and marchy and all the rest of it, and this is just an absolute gem. Still from Annie, get me going. Rumors fly, but they often leave a doubt. Stop before we get to the chorus and see if you know it. unless the tune, oh no, it's good, the tune isn't in the introduction.
It's not that.
I touch your hand and my heart grows strong, like a pair of birds that burst with song. I turn my eyes to your lovely face, who thinks they know it? It is not some enchanted evening. Who said that over there? Oh, well done. Younger than springtime, exactly. Some enchanted evening, this nearly was mine. Happy talk, nothing like a dame. Watch that man right out of there, my head. Everybody forgets younger than springtime.
Sit down, you're rocking the boat.
And the devil will drag you under by the sharp lapel on your checkered coat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down.
Sit down, you're a rock in the boat. We sailed away on that little boat to heaven, and by some chance found a bottle in my fist, and there I stood nicely passing out the whiskey, but the passengers were bound to resist. For the people all said, beware, you're on a heavenly trip. The people all said, beware, beware, you'll scuttle the ship. And the devil will drag you under by the fancy tie around your wicked throat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down. Sit down, you're rocking the boat. And as I laughed at those passengers to heaven, second act where we go for a few newer musicals with two Leviathans of, well, one Leviathan from modern theatre and one from opera, Messrs. Bernstein and Sondheim, with a little number from West Side Story, an absolute masterpiece. Something's coming.
Could be. Soon as it shows, it may come cannonball down from the sky, gleaming its eye, bright as a rose. Who knows? It's only just out of reach, down the block, on a beach, under a tree. Something's coming.
Yeah, we're about to go. Thank you. Yeah.
second act, we're going to the more modern musicals. And it was very nice to hear from some of you that you knew some of the songs I was singing, or lots of the songs I was singing. You may know some of these, but here's one you definitely don't. This was my West End premiere show. This was the first show I went to the West End on London. And I was playing this, it was the best character, probably one of the best roles I ever played. I was playing this complete rogue and a cat. It was the musical Napoleon, written by two friends of mine, Tim Williams and Andrew Sabiston. They weren't friends at the time, they became friends. Tim Williams is now a big Hollywood composer, does quite a lot of really big films. And this hit the West End in 2001. I was thrilled to get the role of Charles, who was essentially having an affair with Josephine behind Napoleon's back. It was super role. There's no kids in, right? Right. So, there's this great scene. So most of the time I'm sort of like turning up with some villainous music and carrying on with Napoleon, with Josephine. Not Napoleon, excuse me. And there's this scene in the billiard room. Well, long story short, I was quoted in the Times, the London Times, the oldest newspaper, the oldest running newspaper in the world, as having the worst line in musical theatre. This is true, this is absolutely true. So it's this billiard scene, and it's kind of a bit of a debauched, drunken scene. I'm drunkenly laughing, and please cover your ears over there. It's not terrible. So I throw Josephine on the table, on the pool table, and I come up with, this was the immortal line, the worst line in musical theatre. Look, my dear, I'm coming for you. It's time that you played with my ball and my cue. The worst line in musical theatre history. But I'm going to give you one of Napoleon's songs.
Deadly storm.
one of my favourite musicals. I also have fond memories from meeting my wife. This was the first show we ever went to see. A slightly risque musical, but essentially Sesame Street, but for adults. But I'm not going to do a rude song. In fact, I think I even cleaned up the one rude lyric, I hope. And it's a really good song. Purpose. It's that little plane that lights a fire under your ass. Oh, I forgot that one. Purpose keeps you going strong like a car with a full tank of gas. Everyone else has a purpose, so what's mine? Hey, wait. I found a penny. It's from the year I was born. It's a sign. I don't know how I know, but I'm gonna find my purpose. I don't know where I'm gonna look, but I gotta find my purpose. Got to find out, don't wanna wait. Gotta make sure that my life will be great. Gotta find my purpose before it's too late. I gotta find my purpose. Oh, could be far, could be near. A year, at a job, maybe mowing grass, or maybe at a pottery class. Could it be? Yes, it could. Something's coming, something good. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Where will it be? My purpose in life is a mystery. I've gotta find my purpose. Gotta be me. I'm gonna find it. Purpose, purpose, purpose. Yeah. I gotta find me. Could. I was in a show, a little show called Phantom of the Opera, for a number of eels, which is why I find it so easy to forget the words, oddly enough. I was encyclopedic on them a long time ago. So I was in Phantom of the Opera for, I'm going to say, 3 years, national tour, West End, and I played Raoul, the romantic guy, the one who sings All I Ask of You. I wasn't always romantic when I did it. It was a great moment. One time, I don't want to break the illusion for anybody, but they don't actually have a lake on stage in Phantom of the Opera. But they do a lot of dry ice. And one night, they did too much. And it's all at the back, because that's where the boat arrives, and it pulls all this sort of lovely smoke and steam. And so when Raoul comes out for his bows, he's sort of like almost last. There's him, then Christine, then Phantom, and all the ensemble and the featured ensemble part. And Raoul comes out, turns and comes upstage, and takes a bow. And the thing about dry ice is, it's very slippery. And I came on. And I kid you not, landed on my butt and slid off the other side. This is an absolute fact. It is my 7-year-old daughter's favorite thing about me. She makes me tell it a lot. But it is absolutely true. I have more stories, but I think we'll sing something from Phantom first.
Thank you.
are on it, bang on, and you are absolutely fine singing it, you can always hear this. And I had it when I was auditioning.
No.
True, sorry. Anyway, so I'm playing Raoul. And I think you can all agree that because you can't see the words, I've done a great job learning all the words. Rebecca A, don't know. Oh, Rebecca A, thank you for remembering the words. Yeah, not always my strong suit. In Phantom of the Opera, there's a wonderful scene called the dressing room scene, in which Christine is just saying, she sang her dressing room afterwards, combing her hair. Actually not, because it's a wig. But pretending to comb her hair. And Raoul comes in with the owners, the managers of the theatre, and comes and visits her in her dressing room, because it turns out they'd known each other when they were younger. And they had this little poemy thing that they did, which goes like this. Little Lottie, let her mind wander. Little Lottie, thought her out. Am I fonder of goblins or of dolls of shoes?
Oh, Raoul, so it is you.
Literally, she says that. Well done. So, I'm about to come on. Done it, you know, hundreds of times. And I'm stood in the wings, and as I always do, think, what's my first line? What's my first line? What is my first line? What's my first line? And so the two managers who come in with me do a little bit of dialogue and then leave me. What's my first line? What's my first? They're like, ooh. They literally walk off laughing, going, ha ha ha, you must have known her from before, implying that I was a bit of a cad and had some fling with her or something. So I'm going on the whole thing. Christine dying?
Monsieur?
Where is your red scarf?
Oh, Raoul, so it is you.
Little Lottie, let her mind wander. Little Lottie, thought am I fonder of dogs or of cats or of goats? Christine delivered every line for the rest of the scene facing upstage. Like that. True story. There's only 2,000 people watching, so that's okay. the other one. The other thing that goes wrong a lot, technical stuff. And Phantom, I mean, you forget nowadays with all of the amazing stuff that goes on in shows, the magic screens and magic effects. Phantom was all analog stuff. The chandelier that swung in, that was jaw-dropping in its time. I mean, you forget how seminal and amazing it was the first time people heard the all of this sort of stuff. But not everything always worked that well, like the dry ice machine for one. So there's a scene in which the Phantom has been disobeyed about people searching for him, and he, as punishment, hangs people with his magical lasso, which appears from nowhere. It's a little string. You can't see it. But it appears from nowhere. Now, we had a gentleman called Bouquet. The role is Bouquet, Chief of the Flies. So everything's going wrong, sets are falling over, and there's all drama. And the manager says, get Bouquet, Chief of the Flies. He'll know what to do. And Bouquet, Chief of the Flies, comes down from the roof, hanging from the magical lasso noose. Big dramatic moment. Everybody goes, and runs off. And then it goes to Raoul. Raoul grabs Christine and takes her off to protect her. Well, we had a Bouquet who was 6'10". Genuinely, lovely guy called Colin Fay. 6'10", and not a skinny beanpole guy. He was a brick wall. And so the way they built the dummy was they have this like central stanchion, central collar. They did a column, and they have a dummy around it. But it's still huge, because it can't have a miniature version for that. So, Bouquet, Chief of the Flies, He's responsible for this. Bouquet, where are you? Bouquet! Then the body falls off. The head rolls to the front of the stage. Colin Fay had white hair and a big white beard. He looked like Santa Claus on steroids. So it's not even like duck, big, white, furry head, staring straight out by sheer luck.
It's a tragedy, we'll have to close.
Everybody's laughing on stage, panic goes.
I run on, grab Christine. Christine!
We get up to the rooftop scene. Why have... So, and it was the same show that obviously emboldened the audience to think it was interactive. We were in Edinburgh at the time, doing the show in Edinburgh. Anybody ever heard a Scottish person speak? Right. So.
Anywhere you go, let me go to Christine. That's all I ask of you.
Kiss, big kiss in the middle of the stage. From the middle of the orchestra.
Hey, give one from me!
All in one show. So I'm gonna move on. In a way that Lord Webber didn't. Because he wrote Phantom 2, Love Never Dies. Could have also been called Phantom 2, No One Ever Watches It. But there was a fantastic song from it. And I just wanted to do it because I don't think there's any other way to do a sequel character in musical theatre. So I sang you a little bit, sang the music of the night. Phantom, 10 years on. Coney Island. Oh, except Coney Island. Went from the opera populaire in Paris to Coney Island. I didn't write it. I've ruined the moon now.
Till I hear you sing one.
music, it teases at my ear. I turn, then it fades away, and you're not here. Let hopes fly, let dreams pass, let them die. Without you, what are they for? Musicals that are guilty pleasures that I've listened to 1,000 times. Rocky Horror Show is one of them. Contemporary, I know. Starlight Express, very guilty pleasure. another Lloyd Webber. Terrible musical, but I love it. This is one that, it's not really a guilty pleasure because it's all the music of Louis Jordan, who's a great jazz writer from the 30s and 40s, adapted by Joe Green, this one. From the musical, so the reason I say that's a musical I just listened to on loop over and over again, because it just kept me in this wonderful, great mood, always happy. And this is from Five Guys Named Moe. Music for the Broadway musical The Addams Family. So, and as you'd expect, some of the songs are a little quirky, and it does remind us that love is not always exactly where you think you're going to find it. Not the first words. I'm sorry, I just started that, but that's done. Oh, that's right. I hear a lyric I cannot remember now. I hear the music, yeah. I hear a music I have never heard before. I feel the waves though I am nowhere near. In the arms of a squid, I found my secret longing. Hang on, I've got the words wrong again, I apologize. Hang on, I've got to remember this. Sorry. What did I do with it? I blame my administrator. Sorry, apologies. I'm going to carry on. I'm going to go from that. I was right, wasn't I? I was actually right. Yes. In the arms of a squid, I found my secret longing, all embraced as I faced a world both warm and new. And in the arms of a squid, I lost my inhibitions and found my love for you. And in the arms of a squid, all tentacled and squishy, rearranged, I was changed by something sort of fishy. For at once, as I hugged a thousand cups of suction, I found my love for you. Who'd have thought that I'd discover God cuddling with a two-ton cephalopod? Beauty and the Beast, Bits of the Lion King, Little Mermaid, Princess and the Frog, hang on, there's more as well. Oh, it's got Hercules. Oh my goodness, all these musicals, and they all have different styles. He also wrote one of my favourite musicals, Little Shop of Horrors. Alan Menken. And do you know what?
Galore, each built 6 foot 4,
each one stuffed with every guest on team. You'll be keeping house with pride, each day gratified that you are part of this idyllic scene. I can see that we will share all that love implies. We shall make the perfect pair, rather like my thighs. You are face to face with destiny. All roads lead to the best things in life are all's well that ends with me.
Which was Les Miserables. And so I was going to do some Les Miserables, and I thought, well, that's a bit miserable. As it is. Empty chairs and empty table. Drink with me because we'll die. Honestly, everything at the end of the day, another thing older. God! So I thought, let's skip that one. I looked at Martin Guerre, which I love, the original Martin Guerre. Everybody else hated it, so they rewrote it. So if they wasn't good enough for them, it wasn't good enough for me. Rebecca, no one heard of. Pirate Queen, no one cared about. So I went to my favorite, which was their sort of big follow-up, based on Madame Butterfly, excuse me. Miss Saigon. My absolute favourite. Was anybody there for the MAGA event last week? I sang this last week. So it's the only song I should know the words for. Which now means I'm definitely going to forget it. In fact, I'm going to look at 1 second. There is one bit. Hang on. You know, saving a nice easy one for after I've been singing for an hour and a half. I actually am feeling this now. Why, God, why? Why does Saigon never sleep at night? Why does this girl smell of orange trees? How can I feel good when nothing's right? Why is she cool when there is no breeze? Vietnam, you don't give answers, do you, friend? Just questions that don't ever end. Vietnam. Hey, wait, I mean you no offense.
But why does nothing here make sense?
Leave? Thank you.